So you're looking to insulate your house with injection foam, but you don't have any sheathing on your exterior walls. What do you do now? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about if you want to inject your walls with foam insulation, but you do not have any sheathing, what are your options? So before we get into this, please go below, hit that like button for us. It really helps out the channel. So you've made the smart decision. I want to put foam in my walls, but then you realize I don't have any sheathing underneath the siding. Is foam an option now? No, it's absolutely not an option, unfortunately, and here is why. If we go to remove some siding and we realize there's no sheathing, even if we wanted to try to run the hose down every stud cavity and inject foam into those stud cavities, what would happen is the foam would bow out the siding. And what you would end up with a finished product is your siding would be really wavy all up and down your walls, and it would look terrible. You would not like it. Also, aside from the aesthetics, the foam would not set up properly because it's not in an enclosed tight area. That foam is really designed to be in a closed spot where it can cure properly and set up. If that's not the case, like I said, it's not gonna wanna set up properly. It's gonna be overexposed to air. It's gonna have other problems. You're not gonna end up with a good product. And like I said, it's going to look terrible. You will hate the look of your house. And we've had this run in a few times where we go to take off siding and there is no sheathing. Most homeowners in this situation are completely unaware of it. That's pretty common. However, if you are aware, you know you don't have any sheathing underneath the walls. And when I say sheathing, keep in mind, foam board does not count. Foam board, because of how brittle it is, if you go to inject behind it, it will crack and break and you will have the same result. You will have that bowed look on your siding because the foam board's just not sturdy enough to contain the foam inside the cavity. So keep that in mind. So what are your options? Unfortunately, at this point, you're looking at a pretty invasive process. The best thing that we recommend, take all the siding down, have someone put up sheathing. You can insulate at that point and then put the siding back on, whether you want to re-side with new stuff or put the existing siding back on. However, keep in mind, if you're looking to insulate those walls and you have no sheathing, unfortunately, you are looking at an invasive process, but please get contractors involved. If you reach out to someone like us, we'll tell you that. We'll tell you the steps that you need to take. We'll help you along the way. Also, if you reach out to the contractors at the beginning of that process, all those contractors can coordinate with each other and they can communicate and say, well, I'll be done on this day, and the following day, the next trade can come in and get their work started and so on. So when you're looking at this project, make sure everyone's talking to each other and on the same page. So if you want to learn more about how to insulate your house with no sheathing, please check out the link below. Don't forget, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.